What's up guys, my name is Ace, and something new that was added with Season 4 Reloaded that I briefly touched on but didn't really break down is the Underbarrel Dragon's Breath Shotgun, also known as the Corvus Torch. So today, I wanted to take a good look at this Corvus Torch Underbarrel, compare it to the Underbarrel Masterkey Shotgun that was already in the game, to see just how it stacks up and whether or not it's overpowered or underpowered or just fine as it is. Now just a quick note on this, they actually nerfed this already yesterday, so all of this testing that I've done here is post-patch, it's after that nerf. Unfortunately, I didn't do any deep testing pre-patch, so I can't really share what it was like before they nerfed this. But without further ado, let's start this off with a list of weapons that we can use these Underbarrel shotguns on, because you can't use them on all of the guns in the game. Now when it comes to assault rifles, we can use these Underbarrel shotguns on most of the assault rifles. The only exceptions are going to be the STB-556, the Kassov 74U, the Chimera, and the Tempest Razorback. All of the other assault rifles can use both of these Underbarrel shotguns. Then with battle rifles, you can use the Underbarrel shotguns on the FTAC Recon, the TAC-V, and the Cronin Squall. Then for shotguns, if you want to really double things up, you can use these Underbarrel shotguns on the KV Broadside. And then finally, for marksman rifles, with the Tempest Torrent, you can use the Masterkey shotgun, but you can't use this new Torch Underbarrel shotgun for some reason. And that's it, those are the only guns in the game that you can use these Underbarrel shotguns on. Now let's get into what's likely the most important part of this breakdown. This is our range comparison. And as we can see here, it's not even close between these two different underbarrels. With the standard Masterkey, the non-Dragon's Breath version, our one-shot kill potential is just below 10 meters, which is pretty solid, although you do have to be nicely centered and aim down sight on your target. However, it's basically a guaranteed one-shot kill out to about 3 meters with the Masterkey. And our maximum hit potential is 24 meters with the Masterkey. Whereas with the Corvus Torch, we can't even hit our target beyond 18 meters. And more importantly, our one-shot kill potential is just 3 meters. Anything beyond 3 meters, even if you hit every single pellet on the enemy player, you can't get a one-shot kill against them. And this really has me wondering what this Corvus Torch looked like before they ended up nerfing it. I just didn't get the time to go in and do the testing on this. But to me at least, it looks like they possibly over-nerfed this, because I can't see any reason whatsoever right now to use the Corvus Torch over the Underbarrel Masterkey. But just to put this into a bit more perspective, I wanted to compare both of these to the most similar counterpart out of the actual shotgun category, which is the Expedite 12. With the Expedite, we have a very similar rate of fire, it's just slightly slower than the others, but not even by a noticeable degree. And as we can see, our maximum hit potential is pretty comparable to the Masterkey, but our one-shot kill potential is slightly better, and also our essentially guaranteed one-shot kill potential is a bit better as well, at about 4 meters with the Expedite 12. So honestly, the Masterkey is quite similar to the Expedite, although the Expedite is a little bit better, which is expected. I mean, that's a full-on gun, not just an attachment like the Masterkey is. And honestly, I was actually a little bit surprised that the Masterkey held up so well against the Expedite 12. So there we go, those are the ranges, and those are very important stats to be looking at, but there are a few other really key features with these Underbarrel shotguns that I wanted to make sure I'm covering. And first up, we'll just compare the rate of fire and time to kill, and it turns out the Masterkey and the Torch are identical in these areas. Both of them have a rate of fire of 133 rounds per minute, which means our two-shot time to kill is quite slow at 450 milliseconds. Then our aim down sight times, again, are identical between these at 280 milliseconds. And it's the same story with our sprint out times. This is 210 milliseconds for our standard sprint out time and 310 milliseconds for our tactical sprint out time. And with both of these values, the aim down sight and sprint out times, there is something that's interesting to point out, and that is these are fixed values and therefore attachments have no impact on the aim down sight or sprint out time while using these shotguns. So you can stack up really heavily on attachments that improve your sprint out time or your aim down sight time. And while that will help with the base version of the gun when you're using the gun normally, the moment you switch over to one of these Underbarrel shotguns, all those benefits just disappear and you're stuck with these values. As for movement speeds though, these are just tied to whatever the current movement speed is on the gun that you're using, and these are impacted by attachments. So if you stack really heavy on attachments that slow your movement speed down, you're gonna get that same movement speed when you swap over to the shotgun. And honestly, that part's not all that surprising, that just makes sense. As for another really important stat to look at though, this is how long does it take to swap over to this shotgun before you can get a shot off. And with both of these, again, they just work exactly the same here. It takes exactly 400 milliseconds from the moment you hit that swap button to the moment you're able to fire the shot. And that's honestly pretty quick. Just as a comparison, if we're using a secondary weapon like a P890, for instance, just a common pistol, swapping from an M4 to a P890 before you can fire a shot is actually a bit slower at 434 milliseconds. And if you were running overkill with a shotgun, for instance, this would take significantly longer. So this is actually a pretty big upside to using these, is you can swap over to them reasonably quickly and get that finisher on somebody. If you've already hurt somebody, these can often be great as an essentially guaranteed finisher, because you just swap over to them before you approach, and hitting them basically anywhere will easily finish them off in one shot. And then finally, for the comparison here, I just wanted to look at our ammo capacity to see if it's the same, and it turns out it is. Our magazine capacity is going to be 4 shells for both of these, and our total starting ammo, including the mag we spawn with that's already loaded, this is 24 shells, which is pretty good amount of starting ammo considering this is just an attachment and not an entirely new weapon. And with that, that's going to wrap it up for all of the important stats that I wanted to cover when looking at these underbarrel shotguns. As for the comparison between them, I'm sure it's no surprise to you guys. There is no reason to ever use that Torch underbarrel shotgun at the moment. It appears they've completely over-nerfed this, and you're honestly just wasting an attachment slot if you use this. You're much better off using that underbarrel master key if you decide that you do want to use one of these underbarrels. Personally for me, I've never really used these a whole lot, and I don't intend on switching anytime soon, even after this breakdown, and even after finding out the underbarrel master key is pretty solid. It's pretty comparable to the Expedite. It's just something that doesn't really suit my playstyle all that much, and I'd generally rather have an underbarrel attachment that's going to be helping me with my recoil stabilization a decent amount. And more often than not, I'd rather just use the gun itself and not have to swap over to this attachment to use it. In saying that though, I think it's nice that these exist in the game. They just provide a little bit more variety, and they offer different ways to approach the game and play the game, and I'm sure there are several people out there that do enjoy using these underbarrels. Also, just some brief thoughts on the balance between these. Honestly, I was quite surprised to see how useless that Torch underbarrel is. And don't get me wrong, I appreciate the fact that they're using caution with this underbarrel Dragon's Breath. I'd much rather it be too weak rather than be way too strong. But as it is right now, I think they've got it so weak that there's no point in ever even using it. So I think perhaps they did end up over-nerfing this a little bit. Of course, these are just my thoughts and opinions, and I'd love to hear what you guys think about this comparison in those comments down below. First off, were you guys surprised to see the massive discrepancy in power between these two? Did you expect the Torch to be so useless? And second, what are your general thoughts on these underbarrel shotguns? Do you ever use them? Do you see yourself ever using them now that you guys have seen this video? Or are you more like me, where you're not really into these underbarrel shotguns and you'd much rather use a different underbarrel attachment that's going to be helping you more with things like recoil or maybe hipfire spread? Just let me know all of those thoughts down below. If you enjoyed the video, a like rating is always appreciated. And don't forget to subscribe for more if you haven't already. I'll talk to you guys next time.